Good afternoon, everybody. I hope you guys are doing well today. We're going to start today off with a little bit of scripture. I'm going to be in Proverbs chapter 15, verse 29, and it says, "The Lord is far from the wicked, but he hears the prayer of the righteous." If you move on over to Isaiah chapter 59, verse 2, it says, "But your iniquities have made a separation between you and your God, and your sins have hidden his face from you so that he does not hear." I want to talk a little bit today about prayer. I've seen a lot of people, unbelievers lately, saying that I'm praying for this person, or I pray every day, and I just finally had to make a video about it. So first I want to say that prayer is a privilege and a benefit of those who have put their trust in the Lord. We as Christians who have decided to follow Jesus, we come to the Lord and our hearts are pure before him because the Holy Spirit lives inside of us. So that is a privilege that we get to have. We get to have that one-on-one conversation with the Lord. If you're wicked and you're an unbeliever, you are loving the things of this life, and you're loving the life of a sinner. So he will not hear those prayers of the people that are in the world and of the world. We're all sinners, of course, but the difference between those who have chosen to receive Jesus and those in the world are that the people who have received Jesus are washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. People of the world like to pray when things get hard, and when their life gets hard or they want something, they'll pray. They'll throw a prayer out, kind of like a popcorn prayer. Well, they'll just throw out, "I want this," or "I want that," or "Please help me with this," or "Please help me with that." It's kind of like a short, half-hearted prayer. It doesn't have any meaning to it, and it's almost like it just goes up to the ceiling or up against the wall. They just basically say, "Here, God, here's my problems. Take care of it for me. Thanks, though." But the rest of the time, they want nothing to do with Christ. They don't want anything to do with the Bible. They kind of treat God like he's their personal little genie in a bottle, where they can just rub the lamp and he'll give me what I want. Lots of people like to say that they pray, like I said earlier, they pray every day, or they pray for you, but they're just talking to themselves. Unless they are coming to the one who created the world and are asking him to take their life, and unless they are coming to him in worship and repentance, seeking the things of him, he does not hear their prayers. They must think, or they may think that he has blessed them and answered their prayers, but if you look closer and if you look deeper, you will see that they themselves orchestrated the things to work out in their favor because they wanted something to happen. So they kind of worked it out in their favor, and then they say, "Well, you know, God answered my prayers." Now, that's not to say that God doesn't answer prayers of some people who pray, because, you know, that answered prayer in turn will make them accept Christ in the end. So if you can say that he allowed it for that simple reason, because he knew that they would come to him in the end. But then you have others who refuse everything the Bible says. They don't want their lives changed, and they don't want to live for him, but they want to live for themselves. Again, he's not hearing their prayer because they're not coming to him in repentance. They're not coming to him asking him to take their life and to fill them with the Holy Spirit. They are just using him as their grocery store, or like I said, a personal genie to, you know, give me this or give me that. When someone is saved and they pray, they enter the throne room of God. You are directly speaking to the one who saved you, and he is speaking directly to you and through you. When we are saved, we have the Holy Spirit dwelling in us, and He works through us and speaks to us. And it is the privilege of the saved to have that close relationship with the Holy God. We begin to feel His nearness and hear His call, and we also begin to see His hand working in our lives. He doesn't always answer our prayers, even when a believer asks, because He knows what's best for us even when we don't. He might see what's around the corner that we can't see. And sometimes we act like little children when we want something and we don't get it, and we want it now, and we're in the time in life where everybody wants everything right now. He knows what's best for us. He may say no, but He also may say wait. And He's trying to teach us to trust in Him and to lean on Him and be patient and wait for His answer. And oftentimes He will answer our prayers if we come to Him in the right, with the right intentions and the right heart. If we come to Him with a pure heart and are asking these things with the right intentions, a lot of times He will answer those prayers. If we have a lot of sin in our life that has almost put a separation between you and God, where He might not answer your prayers until you repent. A lot of people will say, well, I'm not a Christian, but God answers my prayers, or I believe that God hears all prayers, or I believe that He hears the prayers of everybody. And I personally don't believe that in myself, because that, like I said, that's a privilege that the believers get to have, the privilege of speaking with the true King, and the privilege of having that relationship. When you are in the world, you don't have that personal relationship with God. And if you say that I'm, praying for you, or I pray for this person, are you praying to the Holy God, the God of the universe, or are you praying to a God that you have made up in your mind, a God that will give you everything that you want, a God that tells you that your life is okay, and your sins are okay, and you've kind of built up this God in your life and in your mind. So with that, I'm going to leave you with that. I know it's kind of short, but I'm on vacation, like I told you guys. So I'm just, wanted to lay that all out there. I was kind of thinking about that and praying about it. And in my Bible, reading this morning, I was coming across those verses in Proverbs and Isaiah, and I felt like I needed to share. If you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ and you would like to know more about Him, please email the address down below, and I would be more than happy to get back with you and answer any questions that you might have. If you need prayer, I would be happy to pray with you and to share the gospel with you. And I just want to tell you guys, I love you guys. I'm praying for each and every one of you. And I hope that you have a blessed and wonderful rest of your day.